¿Cómo empezaremos las clases en esta nueva escuela?
School should be the total opposite of dehumanizing. Kids should be able to feel free, whether it's from their hair to their bodies in a school space. Yeah. Especially if we're trying to intentionally integrate schools. I mean, school integration is not only the right thing to do for our country, for our children to build a better future. It's also actually beneficial for every single child in the classroom to learn from other children of different backgrounds.
Well, yeah. But also in order for students to feel a sense of comfort, we'd have to create something that would unite us.
Definitely.
It'll probably be best if we create a uniform policy for our school.
I mean,
that way students don't feel bad about themselves not having super expensive clothes.
Are you even thinking about the fact that kids have grown and we're under, like, families are under economic duress, and now, like, you're going to be asking them to buy more, you know, shirts? It's just...
Uniforms in general are better.
No, they're not. It doesn't let kids be individuals.
How does individualism connect to white supremacy?
I'm surprised how you're able to rationalize anything.
They look more professional.
How does professionalism feed into white supremacy?
I'm surprised how you're able to rationalize anything.
When you say professional, what you're really saying is that you want people to look white.
It's a way to keep us united.
It's another way of policing black and brown bodies.
Racism is everywhere. Everywhere, all the time. And our job is to call attention to it when we notice it. Wait a minute. That thing that we never question, can we pause on that? Is that racist? Can we do this a different way?
Our job here is to make students feel valued, make them feel seen. So they're not just somebody sitting in a classroom, that people know who they are, that they know their name, that they know their background, their story, that they are valued and recognized no matter where they come from. And that could be something so simple as making eye contact.
Exactly.
And that's what we want. We want students to feel like they belong here, that they feel like they're heard, that if they're having a bad day, they're able to come to any of us and talk about it.
We have to make sure that all students of all backgrounds feel like they are valued and seen, especially in an intentionally integrated school.
Also, not only do we have to do that, but we have to be great leaders to make the change that we want to see in the future. You need to train someone to be able to have a new idea of what it means to lead. Leading, to some extent, is being part of a group of people who all are invested in whatever the thing is, right? I have to make students feel valued.
We have to make students feel valued.
Systemic racism shows itself in all parts of society. It shows itself glaringly in policing, in educational inequities, in housing inequities, job opportunities.
It's in everything. And then it becomes a generational thing. There are no bounds in this. That's why we have to be very intentional and deliberate in undoing it. Just as intentionally and deliberately as systemic racism was built over centuries, we have to intentionally undo it. And we have to be unapologetic about that approach and make it clearly our priority and our goal.